Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding a brief history of 70 years. Now this editorial is written by Pulapre Balakrishnan, and this is important for sociology optional students. Now what is this editorial about? First of all, this is about the denominator. The denominator of religion. And secondly, this is about how politics in India has transited from a phase of divide and rule to polarize and rule. Now, before we understand these two aspects of the editorial, we need to understand the basis of India. Now, on what basis India was created? Now, when India got its independence in 1947, it was created on the basis of liberal values, and the core liberal value was that of secularism. But in the initial texts that were generated during the days of independence in the form of Constitution of India, you don't find this word secularism. Now, why you don't find this word? This is very important. Now, India was created, and with respect to India, challenging the base and the foundation of India, challenging the root and the ethos of India, another nation was also created, and that nation was Pakistan. Now, Pakistan was created on the basis of a religion. So Pakistan was not a secular nation. So Pakistan's root and foundation was based on giving a nation to itself that was based on religion of Muslims, whereas India was created as a nation which had its root in a very sacramental principle, that is the principle of secularism. But really we find this word secularism being used in the initial days. Now, why we haven't used this word? Because ipso facto, by itself, it was believed that India is a secular nation which will be protecting all its minorities. So in 1947 until Jawaharlal Nehru passed away, we had seen a phase whereby religion has lost its importance in the politics. Religion has lost its importance in the denominator how politics was conducted. But later on, during the phase of Indira Gandhi and during the phase of Rajiv Gandhi, we had seen a new transformation taking place in the politics. This transformation was the appeasement of the minorities. Now, like in the initial phase, we have abstained from using this word secularism. But later on, during the phase of Rajiv Gandhi, we were using this word called secularism, and this was also added to the preamble of the Indian Constitution. So the intent of using this word at that point of time was to placate the concerns of the minorities and specifically the Muslim population. So a message was given that the Congress government would be protecting the minorities, that the Congress government will be establishing a secular setup, and it will be standing with the Muslim population. So this was the message given by this word secularism when it was added to the Indian constitution, specifically to the Indian preamble. Though secularism had always been part of the code and the conduct of the politics that was being followed since independence. Now, when this word secularism was added to the Indian constitution, something changed how the politics was conducted. And this change was in the form of that the religion in the denominator began to gain a lot of strength. Religion in the denominator gained a lot of importance. Like I've told you, since independence, its importance was less. But once this word secularism was added, this religion gained a lot of importance. And when this gained a lot of importance, the phenomena of polarization began to take its roots in the Indian political system. And a new formula of ruling, of usurping the power began to be tested. Now the testing of this formula began during the phase of Rajiv Gandhi. And it took about 30 plus years for the BJP to really realize, to really gain the benefits out of this formula. The formula of polarize and rule. So this is very, very important. Now by this polarize and rule, we are throwing away the values that India used to stand for. We have lost the Indianness in the chase of power. We have lost inclusivity in the chase of power. We have lost development in the chase of power. Now, during British era, we had something called as divide and rule. And now we are adding a new layer to it, the layer of polarize and rule. And this is something that is not going to yield positive results. Now, by divide and rule, we had ended up losing one part of the nation. And by this polarize and rule, we again might end up injuring India. And in order to stop this injury, in order to stop this wound, we need to make the things happen in a manner of inclusivity. We should try to engender inclusivity, cultural inclusivity, political inclusivity, economic inclusivity. And we should try to remove this religion denominator. And how can this be done? This can be done if we will be focusing less on the aspect of religion. If we will not be making religion a part of politics. If we will be treating religion as something that is related to oneself. Something that is confined to oneself. Something that is not related to everybody. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. Now you can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you're interested in joining the offline batch and in joining the online classes. And you can also buy our video class packages. Now in order to avail the information of the classes, you can visit BrainyIAS.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.